Okay, kids, please integrate these three functions. First one is super easy. Second one is easy. Third one is almost easy. You'll have to remember what I said. Integration is the reverse of differentiation. For the first one, you have direct formula. So please, 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 please get your answer and then listen any further. Don't just keep on listening. Work it out. For the first one, it's pretty simple. You just have to use the direct formula of integration that we studied. For this one, integration of integral y dx, this will be x to the power 4 minus x cubed plus x squared. Okay? For the second one, now I didn't tell you what is the integration of e to the power x. But I did tell you the differentiation of e to the power x, which is e to the power x. And I did tell you that integration is the reverse of differentiation. So if you differentiate and you e to the power x and you get e to the power x, that means if you integrate e to the power x, you will get back e to the power x. Now if you differentiate and you get something, then on that something, if you integrate, then you will get back the original function. So integration by extension of e to the power x would be e to the power x. So in this case, the integration would be e to the power x. Now, what would you differentiate to get 2 cos theta? Intuitively, you would understand that you have to differentiate 2 sine theta to get 2 cos theta. So integration of 2 cos theta would be 2 sine theta. This is how we check. But we just memorize the formula for differentiation. And this becomes very handy to find out the integration. Differentiation of sine theta is cos theta. So integration of cos theta would be sine theta. Now this one. What would you differentiate to get e to the power 2x? If you simply use e to the power 2x, if you differentiate e to the power 2x, you will have e to the power 2x into 2. By chain rule that we studied before. Now this is what we have. What we have is e to the power 2x. Now you tell, just think from here and see, what would you differentiate to get e to the power 2x? You don't want 2 here, so you should start with 2 in the denominator. So if you differentiate this function, 2 in the denominator will not harm your differentiation process. It is going to remain as it is. When you differentiate e to the power 2x, you get e to the power 2x into 2, and the 2 in the denominator will cancel that 2, and you will get e to the power 2x. So once again, what would you differentiate to get e to the power 2x? You will differentiate e to the power 2x upon 2. You will differentiate this to get e to the power 2x. So when you integrate e to the power 2x, you should get back this. So integration of e to the power 2x would be e to the power 2x plus. Now once again, what would you differentiate to get cos 2x? Now you should get this one, really. You would differentiate sine 2x upon 2. If you differentiate this, then sine 2x cos 2x into 2, 2 to cancel, you get cos 2x. So if you differentiate this, you get cos 2x. So if you integrate cos 2x, you should get back sine 2x upon 2. Because integration is reverse of differentiation. Fine. So this was the basic practice of integration. Now we'll see why did we study this and how this is going to help us in physics. Suppose velocity as a function of time is given like this, and they are asking you what would be the displacement up till t is equal to 1 second. They are asking displacement from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 1 second. Now to find displacement, you should get the expression of displacement. And it would be easy now, because we have been studying it for quite some time, that velocity is ds by dt. So we can just write v as ds by dt. Ds by dt is equal to t squared plus t. Okay, now we are looking for expression of displacement so that we can find what is the displacement at t is equal to 1 second. So the expression of displacement from here we can get ds is equal to t square plus t into dt. Now remember, we saw that integral dx is equal to x. So integral ds will be equal to s, and we also had a discussion that we didn't have discussion, I just told you that integration is summation. When we integrate dx, actually we are summing up. Dx is actually small change in x. Integral dx means we are doing the summation of all the small changes throughout the range that we are looking for. So integral dx is summation of all the small changes. Integral ds is the summation of all the small changes in displacement. So that will be total displacement. The summation of all small displacement will be the total displacement. So ds, if we want displacement, then what we have to do is we have to integrate ds. Now, as any other mathematical operation, we can square both sides of the equality. We can take the square root on both sides of equality. We can divide both sides of equality by a number. We can multiply both sides of equality by a number. We can take cube of the functions on both sides of the equality. Similarly, we can do integration on both sides of the equality. It's a mathematical operation. So from here, what we do is we integrate both sides. This side we get integral ds. This side we get integral t square plus t into dt. Now this we understand. This is integration of t square plus t in terms of t. The integral, that means summation of ds, integral ds, we have seen before, would be equal to s. And this integration will do integration individually term by term and then add them up. Integration of t square is t cube by 3 plus integration of t is t square by 2. See how did we get the expression of displacement? This is very important. I mean, you should really do it on your own and actually think about it. Spend some quality time thinking, how did we get this expression of displacement from the expression of velocity? Now, once you have the expression, you can give the displacement at any time. They're asking for t is equal to 1 second. We just have to put t here as 1. So displacement at t is equal to 1 will be equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2. Fine. So this is how it helps. That's why we studied integration. We'll solve one more example.